Hello everyone, my name is Alice and sometimes I get lost in the Sims, so let's get lost together, shall we? Is it too early to say Merry Christmas? I'm not quite sure, but this is a Christmas build and it's actually one of two Christmas builds that you will see on this channel this year. And this one was built for the holiday collaboration by my friend Erin with a Y. And she also had some help by Yolly Dolly Sims Builds and Helena Builds Sims. And there's quite a few simmers in this collab, so check out the playlist that Erin made and also check the hashtag on Instagram, and I'll provide all of the info down in the description. And yeah, Erin is my friend, as you might have already noticed if you've seen some videos of mine, and that's why I actually made a Christmas build for her, like a proper one with a proper Christmas tree, because I personally am not very fond of Christmas trees. I never get one. And as it's COVID-19 this year and Germany has their cases flaring up again, I won't even have much of a Christmas celebration actually. But I don't mind so much. I mean, I can see my family to some other occasion, so I'm not that super bothered about it. Yeah, so this is pretty much the closest I get to Christmas, I guess, that I'm gonna get this year. And this build is actually centered about this idea I had of, yeah, I already built it. So this winter garden thingy, or I don't know, do you call it sunroom? So this room with the many windows. And I wanted to have the Christmas tree like as the central piece in there. And then I'm building everything else around it. And yeah, I only had this as a plan. And then I just build whatever came to mind, and so this turned out to be a tier 3 micro home or tiny home. No, I think micro home is the first tier, but it's the third tier, so the biggest tiny home that you can have with when you've got the pack tiny home. And yeah, I was going with a white and blue color scheme. I don't know, that just happened somehow. And I was going for like a comfy vibe, like homely vibe. This could very well be a holiday rental, or it could just be a little house where one sim or a couple lives. And I wanted to have like a fireplace in there, because obviously this build is a Christmas build, so it's winter and you will see me working in the snow a little bit later in the video. And yeah, so I thought the fireplace was an essential piece that should be in the build. And I think, as usual, I'm jumping a lot between the rooms. So at the moment you see me doing the bedroom, but that might change at any second. And I was getting inspiration from stuff I found on the build catalog, and I was just running with it. So it's a very creative go with the flow build, I guess. I didn't have like a concrete plan apart from the living room with, or the winter garden with the windows, but I didn't have a plan for the furnishing of this room, so you will see me redoing it completely later. Yeah, and what I'm doing now is like a little kind of makeup area, I guess. So I guess a lady lives there, or a very style-oriented guy, could be as well. Yeah, I've been using every little nook of the build to put in some little table with some little decor on it. And I just wanted to have this comfy, lots of clutter vibe to the build. And every time I was looking for Christmas decoration and I found something, I just put it somewhere, and then sometimes later I'm changing it up again. And also I had my sim do a bit of stuff for me, but you will see that later in the build. And you will also see her standing around in a t-shirt in some shots, but fortunately she didn't die. So actually, by mentioning this, I don't know if you're aware of it, but if you playtest a build with a sim, then always make sure that you've got more than one sim on the lot. And I made the mistake of not doing this time, but thankfully nothing happened, but it could have, because if this single sim you've got on the lot dies, your house vanishes. And it doesn't matter if you saved it before or not, it's gone. So the only way to this not happen, or like to have no risk of this happening, is if you upload it to your personal gallery at first, and also playtest with more than one sim. That's just a tip on the side. So now I'm actually working on the final living room concept, and I'm really happy how this turned out. So at first I was so struggling with the layout of the room, and then I finally found this this triangular shaped sofa, and from that on everything was just flowing. So I've got these cute edges with the sofas, and I later will place some magazines and stuff on them. And then I put this little area with pillows and sheepskins in front of the fireplace. And my idea is that you could lounge there and read your magazine or a book or whatever in front of the fire, and have the fur beneath you as a comfy place to lie down. I mean, obviously the Sims won't lie down on the floor, but they can definitely sit on the cushions and the pillows that are lying there, so that's definitely absolutely possible. And in the bedroom I used some custom artwork from the gallery, and I at the moment I'm not quite sure which account I got it from, but I will credit them in the description definitely, so you can look that up. So you know, you see me placing the nifty knitting hanging plants, and for that I had to type in the show hidden objects cheat. So if you're interested in tutorials about cheats and something like that, then please let me know. But you could just look for them on Google or on YouTube as well, because there's a lot out there. That's how I learned it. Yeah, so I put some little decoration on the fireplace as well, and now I'm putting in some more fairy lights, and I think I'm pretty much done with the interior. I'm not quite sure if you noticed, because it was so quick, but I cut out lots of doing the bathroom, because it's always kind of the same. Although this bathroom I'm actually quite okay with, because I put in some shelves and put some decorations in there. And here outside I also cut in some optimization I did on the roof shape, because I was playing around so much with it, because I wasn't satisfied with the winter garden roof part. And then I found these little thingies from the magic pack, these round things that I put on the edges. I don't know what they're called. And it looked so much better from that point on. So I am now confident about the roof, and I'm happy with it. And before I was not, totally was not. So I'm actually already finalizing the build, with adding some Christmassy details and some lights in the garden. And yes, thank you very much for watching this video. Make sure to check out the other builds in the collab. And if you liked this video, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I upload new videos every Tuesday and Saturday, so I hope I will see you in my next video. Bye!